Last week, I was very fortunate to have the opportunity to attend a pre-launch event for the Fuji X100V, announced today by Fujifilm. Anytime I can get early access, I cherish it, and this was no exception. I flew to New York City, and after a good night's rest, after a long day of travel, I was on foot in the city shooting with this amazing camera. I talk about that experience a little bit more in a video I made for my members. I will link to that down below, but this video is all about the camera. I knew it would be a fun trip for a few reasons. The main reason is that we previously owned a Fuji X100F, which Raymond and I both loved. When we started reading the tea leaves, or in other words, the rumor sites, and seeing that a successor might be on the horizon, we took a gamble and we sold our beloved X100F. We were sad to see it go, and I was a little bit nervous because we didn't really know if its successor was actually coming soon, but we were excited about a potential replacement that might have improvements like 4K video, among other features that you would expect to see in 2020. I'm pleased to say that the X100V has those items and more, with some nice surprises along the way. Because I was only able to use this camera for one day, this video will be a flyover of some of the specifications and what the practical purpose of each is, and I will discuss the shooting experience. And of course, I'll share photos and videos that I captured with the camera in New York. Look for a more in-depth review once I'm able to have the camera in my hands when it is actually released later this month. You can hit the subscribe button and the bell to be notified when my new videos come out. This is a fixed lens, fixed focal length camera. That means that the lens is stuck on there. It is what it is. There's no zooming, though. There are a couple of conversion lenses that you can add to gain some flexibility in terms of focal length. I'll get back to the lens shortly though. But being a fixed lens, fixed focal length camera, it's quick and it's fun to use. The X100V has a 26 megapixel sensor. I'll always take resolution when available, and this is in a tie with a couple of Fuji's interchangeable lens options for the top resolution in their line. This is an APS-C sensor, and 26 megapixels leads the class at this sensor size. Actually, it is the same sensor and processor as some of the other Fuji X series cameras like the X-T3 and X-T30. As before, there's both an optical viewfinder and an electronic viewfinder with easy switching between the two. There are 3.6 million dots on the EVF. Honestly, the detail, clarity, and flexibility of the EVF meant that I only used the optical viewfinder for a second or two just to check it out. And as before, an SD card slot, UHS-1. This should be no problem unless you're a buffer filler, as it may not clear the buffer as quickly as if it had UHS-2. If you are a buffer filler though, this camera might not be on your shopping list for other reasons. Sports and action is not the focus here, but you know what? It's certainly no slouch having the capability to shoot 11 frames per second. The lens is completely redesigned. Fuji commented that this new lens, still a 35mm effective field of view and opening up to a maximum aperture of f2, is sharper at f2 than the X100F and its predecessors. The X100F was by no means terrible at f2, but it did become notably sharper as you stopped down a bit. I will have to do more testing once I have an X100V here in the lab to show how much sharper this new design is at f2. But aside from sharpness, having the ability to allow more light in using a wide aperture like f2 fits into the camera's overall philosophy of being easy to shoot in a lot of situations, including low light or for shallow depth of field effects. I am also pleased to say that the V is 100% compatible with the conversion lenses that were available for previous variants. I mentioned those earlier in this video. I held on to my wide angle conversion lens, which brings the effective field of view to 28mm, and I brought it with me on the New York trip. I used it generously on the X100V. Incidentally, the other available adapter lens brings you to an effective field of view of 50mm. Both do add size to the camera itself, but the entire kit is still smaller than carrying around most APS-C bodies with three f2 prime lenses. 4K video, Yes, it's there. And a wonderful upside surprise, it will push 10-bit 4K 30 frames per second through the HDMI port. Atomos Ninja users rejoice. And if that's not your thing, no worries. Video is great at 4K 8-bit in camera. You can even shoot 1080p at 120 frames per second for slow-mo video. Film simulations on Fuji cameras are one of my favorite things about Fuji cameras. They have added the Eterna film simulation to the X100V, which makes me very happy. To me, it is a calm and kind of dreamy look, and I will expect to use it quite often for the sort of mindful photography that I enjoy with a camera like this. I used the camera intensively all day before I ran the battery down, but it has a USB-C port, which is an update over the previous micro USB port, and I plugged the camera into a battery pack to juice it up a little bit, and I continued taking photos and videos into the evening hours. And a first to the X100 series, the articulating touchscreen, which tilts up and down for some added flexibility, but remains really well integrated. I haven't quite gotten used to using a touchscreen on a camera yet, but I plan to try it out on this one once I have it in my hands again. And the tilt screen is handy, especially if you're doing some stealth photography where you don't want to put the camera up to your face, or if you want to balance the camera on something to take stable video. Note here that the X100V does not have stabilization in the body or in the lens. Like its predecessors, the X100V gives me all the feels from both a photography perspective and the mindfulness that the old school dials and controls bring. In fact, those dials and controls got a revamp, which make them a little bit easier to use by feel alone. For example, the aperture ring and the control ring on the lens have a little more tension to them. They also got rid of the D-pad in lieu of just using the joystick and potentially the touchscreen. I didn't miss the D-pad at all. There are other things that make the camera easy to use. The camera has an in-camera four-stop neutral density filter. The camera is weather sealed, but you need to add the accessory ring and a filter on the lens to make the entire rig weather sealed. There's a mic jack. I did not use it on this trip, but for me, that means that if I do want to do a little bit of video, including some high quality audio, I can. It has face and eye detect autofocus, which makes photos of people much quicker and easier to capture. I actually assigned a button on the camera body to quickly turn that on and off as I was walking around the city. There are other assignments that you can make on the body to customize your shooting experience as well. For example, I assigned the function ring on the lens to change the film simulation. And last but not least, price. At launch, the camera will be $1,399.95 in the US and $1,799.99 in Canada. To me, the price is completely reasonable, but that's all relative, so I will leave it up to you to consider if it's reasonable for you. Let me sum this up. The camera is small and light. It produces superb image quality without feeling like I have a ball and chain around my neck. I'm often seen with a larger body and a big telephoto lens, but sometimes I want something small and easy and enjoyable to use. And not to mention that the camera is super cute. It comes in two colors, by the way. So because this camera does feel good to use, and quite frankly, I like looking at it, I want it with me. Meaning that I'm creating my art more often, which makes for a happy snap trick. I have cameras that get the job done for me, and I love them, but this type of camera fills my cup, you know? Like the X100F before it, the X100V will be something that Raymond and I grab on our way out the door when we just want to have a good time, walking around the city, a trip to the museum, to a family dinner. Did I mention yet that we'll be ordering this? We'll be ordering it. Now, it is a camera for us, but is it the camera for you? As always, it depends. Most of my viewers already have cameras, even if it's your phone. For myself, it's one lens permanently attached to the camera, high quality, small size, low weight. Don't get me wrong, I like my big rigs, but when the experience is as important as the images, a camera like the X100V gives me those feelings. It kind of makes my fingers tingle to hold it and turn the dials and the rings, and that helps me to go out and shoot. It's a sort of creative reset for me when I use a camera like this. And I've heard the same from many viewers out there. Fuji might be a second camera, but it's the camera that they use for pure enjoyment, while maintaining the ability to control all of the variables and end up with the quality results that we all want. So this is day one for the X100V, and it's not even shipping quite yet, but if you have any thoughts about it or its predecessors, let me know down in the comments. I also mentioned briefly in the beginning of this video that I talk more about this camera in today's members only video. I discuss my experience in New York a little bit more, my experience with the camera, but also how this camera will fit into our evolving collection of cameras. So, members, make sure you check that out if you haven't already. There is a link below to that, and also a link to what membership is if you're interested to find out the additional perks of it. I'll also share a link to pre-order the camera once it is available, and that's it. Thank you for watching.